take your seats. Give God one more shout of praise. Give God one more shout of praise. Turn it up just a little bit. We are excited on this morning. It's like I had a spiritual reboost. Spiritual Red Bull kick. And we're going to spend this month dealing with the subject of healing. Now, not the spooky kind of stuff you think about when you think about healing in church. I'm not going to blow a spit bubble and throw it out in the audience and you're going to fall out and be made whole. I'm not going to wipe my face with my towel and charge you $100 to receive the residual of my sweat. I'm not talking about the spooky stuff. I'm talking about the word of God. That has the
power to heal
anybody from anything. It's ironic. When I was preparing for this series, you know, I'm always transparent. I'm not afraid to be truthful. So I was preparing for this series, it made me think about some personal things. This ministry, this Greenhouse International Church, was birthed 9 years ago during one of the most difficult times of my life. The church I was pastoring in Northeast Houston was growing and reaching status and prominence, and the Lord decided to open up the heavens and allow it to start to rain. And after a week of rain and about 14 hours on Friday, it started raining about 6 p.m. one Friday, didn't stop till about 12 noon the next day. Everything the young preacher had worked for and put stock in was now wiped out, causing me to experience $1 million loss in assets. And I could probably have dealt with that, but while I was losing all my money, my 21-day-old baby girl died. So now I'm mad at God and broken from my story. I didn't have the energy to deal with my own grief. So I took it out on my wife and decided I didn't even want to be married anymore. I was ready to throw in the towel and give up on everything. A broken man. A wounded man.
Jesus.
I felt like I was under attack, pal. And that God had turned his back on me. But the amazing thing through this dark transition of my life, right, I was never able to close up my Bible.
All right.
Even though I was messed up, I stayed in the Word. Because I knew and I all knew if I ever left the Word, I would go to a world that I would get lost in. And I would end up worse than the prodigal son in the whole pen of life. So I stayed in the Word. And while I was in the midst of the Word, the Lord said, "Son, now I'm getting ready to restore you and raise you up." He took me to the book of Matthew chapter 11. I'm asking you, if you will, stand with me. The book of Matthew chapter 11, verse 28. This is the text that birthed out this ministry. Matthew chapter 11, verse 28. "In my darkest hour, hurting, grieving, frustrated and irritated, the Lord made me focus daily on Matthew 11 and 28 until the Spirit released me from it. Healing. God said, 'Son, come to me. all who are weary and burdened.
Yeah.
And I will give you rest. You can take your seats. Come.
Yeah, come.
To me. Not to another degree, not to another promotion, not to another increase, not to another honorarium, not to another interview, not to another revival, not to another gathering, not to another event, not to another person. But God says, come to me.
Yeah, come to Jesus.
Come to me. Oh, who are weary and burdened, and that sounded like who I was and where I was. I was weary, I was burdened, and you could even add some other adjectives. I was messed up, I was frustrated, I was in a drought. I didn't know which way to go, but God says, come.
Oh, I can relate.